Today, I'm here to talk about the story of a plastic bottle. And you will say, why do we talk about plastic bottles when we are talking about climate change? And I will try to make the connection. And I was saying before, I'm here not to give you a talk, but to give you a tool. This is a picture from the place where I was born, where I grew up. I'm from a coastal town in Spain, in Valencia. And this is the beach we used to go every summer. And this is still the beach that I go every summer, now with my little ones. And if you see from the distance, actually it hasn't changed that much. It kind of looks the same, but actually it is quite different. Something indeed has changed. And I realized, especially after having children, small children, that I started to collect things with them in the beach, seashells and rocks and stones to make sandcastles, that in the last years we collected more plastics than seashells. We started to collect plastic bottles, plastic lids, straws, and also small pieces of different shapes and colors of plastics. And also more recently, we started to collect a lot of face masks. And this is the beach that I have loved and the beach that I want my children to love. And we started to collect more face masks than seashells. Something for sure is wrong with that. If we look, and actually as a researcher, I also study plastics. And I started to look into plastics. What happens with plastics? This is a material, really, really interesting material. And we have seen that since 1950s, exponential growth in the production of plastics. We went from producing less than 2 million tons globally to over 400 million tons globally. We are using a lot of plastics, but that's not the most critical bit, is that most of that plastic will end up being landfill, incinerated, or even worse, on our beaches. So the problem itself is not plastic. Plastic is a material, it is agnostic material. It's not good, it's not bad. It's what we do with plastics. The problem lies in the system. Something in the system is wrong. The system is flawed, and we need to change it. It's a system where we consume a lot of materials. We extract those materials from the earth crust or from the ecosystems. We use them for a period of time. And when we just dispose them as waste, most of our waste, even though some of us think that might be recycled, most of the plastics we use, they end up in landfill, incineration, or in our seas and our soil. So we are not using that material very efficiently. The problem is not plastics. The problem is how we are using plastics and how we have production and consumption systems that use plastic in a very wasteful way. But the problem is even bigger. If we look at the global picture, we are in a developed nation here in UK. We are consuming around 26 tons per capita. Imagine how many skips of things you consume in a year, each of you. But if we look globally, there's countries that consume as little as 2 tons per capita. Something is clearly wrong with this system. So here is the tool that I'm going to give to you today. What if we think of a different system? A system where instead of mining, you do urban mining. A system where you use products for longer, and when you no longer need them, you recycle back their components or their materials to produce new products. What about a system that rather than relying on extracting more things from Earth, recover and regenerate ecosystems and products and materials back into the productive system? What a system that allows us, everyone in this globe, globally, to reduce drastically in some countries the consumption of resources and increase consumption of resources in other countries where they are needed. And what if I tell you that that system already exists and that system is called circular economy? So if we go back to our bottle, what does it mean to be, what does it mean for that plastic bottle to be in a circular economy? First of all, it means that it's produced in a different way. We rely on bio-based materials or we rely on secondary materials to produce our plastic bottle. when we put it in the market, we know exactly what that product contains. We know what it's made of, and we have made sure during the design of that plastic bottle that everything can be either recycled or recovered in a different way. It's a system where we don't produce plastic waste. We use plastic waste to create new plastic products, or we recover the monomers of in that plastics through different processes, especially biological recycling. But the most powerful thing around this tool, circular economy, is that you can apply it to textiles. We were seeing before this sketch from fast fashion. We can apply it to fast fashion. We can apply it to fashion. We can apply it to metals. We can apply it to critical materials. We don't need to extract more materials to have new phones. Maybe we can upgrade our phone without the need to extract more materials. Circular economy is here, and I hope it's a tool that you are going to use to disrupt the way we use resources and the way we challenge or we face climate change. Thank you so much.